今天讲座之前，我先叮咛本是释迦牟尼佛，之后呢，我们可以大家共同了解，也就是说今天的话题，遇见细雨，生活当中所存在的情绪问题。
Before the lecture, Rinpoche has just recited a prayer to Shakyamuni Buddha. And after that, we'll talk about today's topic, happiness in hand, how to work with the emotions in daily life.
平时我讲一些佛教的经论，这种传讲方法是以藏传佛教的传统 方式，而今天呢，改变一种方式，以现在的一些想法和以现在人的一些关注的问题，我们可以共同探讨。So
I always teach the Dharma in the traditional Tibetan ways, and today I want to add something new in our lecture that I want to talk about what nowadays people's concern.
我们生活当中，不少人会寻找生活的幸福。同时呢，我们在生活当中也存在许多情绪的这些问题。在这个时候，我想，首先应该我们了解一下，我们没有克制自己的情绪，在 世间当中，有什么样的过患，有什么样的困难，那么这也是我们应该需要值得关心的事。So
everyone will pursue happiness in daily life, and in the life, it's very important for us to know how to work with the emotional problem. Well, if we do not control our afflictive emotion, there will be many difficulties and defects. So first, we should know what's the defect of not controlling your emotion.
我们今天在座的全球的很多兄弟姐妹，大家都非常清楚，我们现在是二十一世纪的人们，二十一世纪人们的需求，他们的爱好都跟以往的 任何一个时代的人们的娱乐都有一定的差别。First,
greetings to brothers and sisters worldwide. Now we are in the 21st century. The people in the 21st century have quite different hobbies with the people in the ancient times.
我们存在着很多对自身的一些内心的情绪上面的问题。 那么这个不管是东方人还是西方人，在任何一个国家、任何一个人，都需要了解的是，也就是说，我们现在的心态没有调整的话，不要说获得幸福，连基本的生存也有一定的困难。
No matter you are in the East or in the West, in any country, everyone needs to know how to work with the emotional problem. So if you do not control your emotion, then it will be a disaster.
我们现在生活当中的不同身份的人，都遇到了一些情绪上的问题。什么样的情绪上的问题呢？就是实际上情绪都是一种分别念，但这种分别念没有人情它，没有了解它，它会给我们 带来了许许多多的痛苦。
People of different identities all face the problem of emotional problem. So actually, the emotional problem is just a conceptual thought. If you do not recognize the truth or the reality of your thoughts, then you will be suffered from it.
因为我们对心没有很好的调整，产生了很多包括一些无聊的、浮躁的、孤独的，以及心里产生了抑郁症等各种不正常的心态。
Because we do not have the right antidote, so we are experienced boredom, solitude, or depression in daily life.
现在人所追求的生活有很多无聊的，比如说我们现在人们都每天喜欢用一些碎片文化，就每天都看手机。我前一段时间看过一个英国的《每日邮报》这个邮报里面讲到的很有乐趣，说是现在的人们平均6.5分当中要看一下手机。如果这样的话，那每天人们醒觉的时间算，以16个小时为准算的话，那么一天当中至少也是看150次，那150次看自己的手机啊，在一天当中，那这个数字，也就是说这个资料呢，就是显示了什么？我们人们的心理所追求的，应该带有很多无聊的现象。
I think what people is pursuing is kind of boring. We all know what prevails now is the PC culture. So I've heard the news in the Daily Poster. It is that one people will check up his cell phone in every 6.5 minutes. So we all know people will be awake about 16 hours per day. So that will be 150 times a day to check up your cell phone. This indicates how boring our life is.
因为我们大城市里面的人大多数都经常过一会儿看一下手机，甚至自己最好的朋友、最好的情人在自己的面前的话，他就基本上没有跟他共同的语言，他就过一会儿又看自己的手机，所以两个人的共同的这样的关系呢，就是越来越疏远。这也是现在虽然我们周围人很多，但是每一个人他所追求的也是自我的、自私的。
People in metropolitan, they will go through such kind of phenomena. Even when they faced with their family members or good friends, they do not have much things in common to talk about. When they gather together, they just checking their cell phones and do not have many interactions. So this indicates we distant each other, and this indicates how selfish we are.
现在很多人人们就不追求信仰，也不追求艺术和哲学，每天都是看低头看自己的手机。所以现在很多人应该知道这叫做是低头症，也就是说这是这几年以来新发现的一个名词。
Well, I think many people do not pursue things or philosophy or art, so they are so boring. And we've heard a new term called furbing. It is described this kind of phenomena that when we gather together, we just check up our cell phones and do not enter and having communication with each other.
地图中，实际上是它是一个一种性的代词。它这里的意思呢，就是说，书记与冷落，祝贺的一种新词。也就是说，2012年的时候呢，澳大利亚的国家的新词典当中已经开始产生了。那么通过这种信息，我们可以看出来，现在的人们呢，也有以往不同的很多的病症。
Well, fibbing is a new term coined by Australian Dictionary in 2012, which described the rudeness and difference between people. I think this indicates the people in the 21st century have many unique characteristics.
其实，我们每个人，不管是电脑还是手机，这些器材可以利用。我们现在是一个特殊的时代，但是我们自己没有价值观，自己没有信仰，如果整天的以现在的非常简单的词或者是画面或者是一些影片来度过自己的非常珍贵的人生的话呢，这恐怕是有点可惜。
Each of us will use cell phone and computers in their life, and on the one hand, we can make use of such convenient devices. But if we lack the core value of things, just to kill our time by movies or simple culture, I think that will be very pity, for you have this precious life.
现在的时代当中的很多人将自己的情绪没有很好的去调整，这样之后在这个世界上有许多人带着各种不同的一些综合症，还有抑郁症和孤独症等等。
In this day and age, since we do not know how to control our emotion, how to work with our emotional problem, so there are many sickness such as depression or the sickness of solitude or antisocialness.
因为我们心很浮躁，这样之后表面上看来很多非常成功的人，经常将自己的一些言行举止来帮助别人，但是呢他们内心当中有困惑焦虑，一直呢不开心，甚至处于一种烦恼和绝望当中。
I think people are unrighteous at all goals. At a glance, some successful people they even help people in their in their daily life, but inside they may experience the confusion, anxiety, unhappiness, and afflictive emotions, as well as depression.
这样的这种心态没有调整而出现就是非常不好的后果的这种现象呢也比较多，比如上个月大概是八月份吧，在这个时候呢，美国非常著名的戏剧家就威廉姆斯啊，他是在活着的时候是应该跟无数的人带了新的力量或者给他们欢悦，可是自己呢最后因为心态没办法调整，产生了极大的抑郁症和烦恼，后来呢选择自杀。
As we all know, if we do not adjust our mindset, there will be very terrible result. Last month, the U.S. comedian Robin Williams had committed suicide at his home. We all know that when he was alive, he brought the laughter and inner strength to many people in this world. But finally, because he did not know how to adjust his mindset, he did not know how to deal with his depression, he finally chose to commit suicide.
这一边呢，全世界的很多人也是感到非常的震惊，包括美国总统奥巴马，他也是，我记得是这样说过，他说，因为他的事实呢，就是对美国来讲是很遗憾的，他有时候呢给我们带来一种毒效，他有时候呢给我们带来一种可以说是一种热阔。不管怎么样，他无与伦比的这种戏剧的这个天才，给很多人带来就无上的欢悦。不管是美国在当地的一些边缘的群体也好，或者是在外的一些士兵，都是在从他的身上获得了欢悦和力量。
And his news of death shocked everyone in this world. US President Obama had a comment on this sad news. He said his death will be a loss to many people. When he was alive, he bring us laughter, he bring us cry, and he gave his generous and freely, he gave us his talent generous and freely to the people. No matter patient outside US or marginalized on the street.
他的死亡呢，全世界的很多人们呢也在分析，但是我作为一个佛教徒呢，这样，绝对是不管是有钱的人、有才华的人、有地位的人，都如果我们内心没有很好的调伏或者说净化，那这样的话呢？实际上就是说我们最后所选择的不一定是很明智的。
So nearly everyone in this world is analyzing his death and we are wondering why he committed suicide. I think people, no matter you're with money or with talent, if you cannot tame your mind, that will be very unwise for you.
因此我想我们在座的经常观察自己的情绪，其实情绪呢应该认识它的本体也很重要，如果没有认识它的本体，我们经常会发生一些心态上的平衡，包括一些嗔恨发怒，或者说自己的心灵的这种烦恼等等。
So I think what everyone should bear in mind is we need to examine our emotion, we need to recognize the reality of our emotion. If we cannot make it, then we'll have an unbalanced mind which bring about hatred or we will easily to lose our temper.
因为我心态没有很好的去对治自己的烦恼，而产生的各种嗔怒发怒，给个人带来了许多不平衡，同时给家庭、给整个社会乃至国家与国家之间的矛盾冲突，都是我们的情绪没有很好的去调整而导致的。
Without the antidote, the hatred will bring about the unhappiness, personal unhappiness. What's more, the conflicts between the families or the conflicts between the countries is also resulted from this kind of lacking antidote.
就是我们每个人的自己的家里的不管是家里的战争、冷战、吵架，很多的这些争论呢，实际上是我们的心态不平衡而导致的。而像国家之间的一些冲突，包括叙利亚、包括阿富汗以及伊拉克 等等。那么这么多年以来的发生的各种战争，其实是一种不合理的追求，或者说强烈的这种愤怒，在这种心态下就开始发生的，一次而无数的人带来极大的痛苦。
Actually, the conflict or the cars in each family is because of such kind of hatred. And the hatred, the code violence in each family is resulted from such kind of unbalanced mindset. So we may wonder why the wars in Iran or Iraq have experienced such a long time. It is also due to our unrational pursuit and our strong hatred.Such kind of hatred will bring about vast damage in the countries.
所有的不合理的情绪，也就是说无聊也好，怒也好，还有嗔怒、发怒，以及呢现在人们最可怕的欲望、贪婪等等，每一个这些烦恼给我们所带来的痛苦和灾难是无穷无尽的。
No matter boredom or solitude, even the hatred or the desire or attachment which we may fear most, each of such afflictive emotions will bring about countless sufferings.
因此我们这个心态呢实际上是有一种正面的心态，比如说欢喜心呐、还有慈悲心呐、等等，还有一种心态是负面的心态。那负面的心态呢，贪婪呐、沉沦啊、迷茫啊，还有嫉妒心呐、傲慢啊。当当就是这些都是负面的心态，因此在2500多年前，对这种心态呢叫做是三毒或者是五毒，用毒药来比喻的。2000年前有佛陀啊，说的没有佛陀。
So everyone should have positive emotions. Such positive emotions is like joy, compassion, and happiness.Also, there are negative emotions like attachment, hatred, confusion, envy, or presumptuous. 2,500 years ago, Buddha Shakyamuni said those negative emotions can be summed as three poisons or five poisons. He used the metaphor poisons to negative emotion.
我并不是因为我是佛教徒而赞叹佛陀，但是研究这么多年以来，我对东方和西方的一些心理学也感兴趣，但在这个过程当中，我觉得佛教里面所讲到的无毒啊，对个人、对家庭、对社会，乃至全世界的和平呢，也带来极大的危害，所以我自己呢。就坚信不疑，2000多年前，东方文化就是对心理学的研究呢，非常的成熟。
I'm not bragging out the Buddhism, not because I am a Buddhist. Since the many years starting of Buddhism, I also very interested in the psychology.I think what Buddha said, the fine poisons, such kind of negative emotion will do harm to person as well as the family and the society, and also will do harm to the peace of the whole world. So I bear such kind of firm conviction in my mind. I think that what Eastern culture, what 2,500 years ago Shakyamuni had discovered,It's still very useful in today's life.
因为我们现在 代是非常开放的时代，你们每个人愿意接受不愿意接受都是自己的自由，但是无论是什么样的人，我觉得对真理的相信呢，这是我们人类是永远是一个新鲜的话题。
I think we're in a very open age. So whether you accept it or not, it's individual right. But we all need to seek the truth. And seeking truth is a very fresh idea.
这种真理呢，无论是这个现在的科学家也好，古人的宗教的这个创始人，谁发现呢？谁已经圆满的接受的话，我们现在的人，未来的人都不得不承认。如果不承认的话，我想是这个人是否认客观事实的。
No matter who discovered the truth, whether he's a philosopher or he's a religious believer, we all need to believe what he said, because he already discovered it. I think no matter in this age or in the future, people need to recognize what is truth. If you do not recognize the truth, then you are denied the objective. Then you are denying the objective reality.
怎么说？我们这里有信仰没有信仰都可以，但是我想不管是宗教当中还是在其他的人文哲学当中，如果对真理产生怀疑，或者是对真理不去去探索的话呢，这种人格或者说是这种水平呢，需要就值得观察。
Whether you believe it or not, it's your own choice. But in the, no matter in the humanity or in the philosopher, we all need to seek the truth. If you do not even have an interest in seeking the truth, then I think you should further reflect on it.
这是我们知道这个情绪不好的一些没有调整好的一些过失。那下面我想问一下，如果我们的情绪对着好了有很大的一些利益或者功德，首先将我们的人心的健康和身体的健康呢，实际上是密不可分的。那么身体的健康呢，需要依靠这个心灵的健康来就是进行维持下去的。
Above, we will talk about the effect of emotion problem. Then we'll talk about the benefit of work with the emotion. We all know we pay much attention to our physical and mental health.Actually, mental and physical health are closely related to each other. And if you have a healthy mind, then it will enhance your physical health.
如果我们的心态出现一些贪婪、嗔怒等等，这样对人的整个免疫系统，对人的整个身体呢，这个四大上就是会出现一些破坏，或者说是出现一些影响。所以在座的各位呢，无论是你在生活当中遇到什么样的状态，你的心平静安宁，一种和蔼，这样的状态的话，自然而然对你的身体健康有了很大的帮助。
If desire and hatred come up to your mind, then it will eat your immune system. So we all know actually mental state will influence our physical state. No matter what position you are in, a calm mind or serenity is equally important to you. Once you have a calm mind, you will automatically have the healthy body.
现在的科学家，也就是说，研究神经系统的，还有脑科学，还有一些神经和医学的这些科学家呢，通过很多试验，发现，心态非常平静的人的，整个免疫系统对抗能力非常强，因此，大多数的身体非常强壮的人、健康的人，他有一个非常健康的清净的一种心灵，所以我们现在的心理健康也成为一个身体健康的根本原因之一。
According to some neuroscientists or brain specialists, they've made an experiment about the relationship between calm mind and healthy body. It is that if you have a calm mind, then you will get a more potent body. As we can see in life, people who has a healthy body will have a healthy mind. So we can conclude that a healthy mind is the root cause of our healthy body.
这一点，我想在汉地、在藏地很多地方，有佛教的修行人，因为他们，心态很平和，参禅呐、念佛啊，就平时没有发生很多的烦恼和痛苦。那这样之后呢，在这些佛教徒的高僧大德啊、修行人当中，活一百岁的，或者说即使年老了，但是身体非常健康的，这种现象呢，非常多的。所以从这个历史或者现实来，也说明我们现在的人的长寿健康，对自己的心灵有极大的关系。
It can be seen in Han area or in Tibetan area. Many Buddhist practitioners seem to have a more calm and peace mind. Since they always do meditations and chantings, they do not have much afflictive emotions. And it is very common among the Buddhist practitioners, those above the 100 years or those who have a high age, also maintain a healthy body. So we can conclude that a healthy mind will bring about your long life.
还有一个，心态的这种平静，实际上，对成功学也有很大的关系，因为一个成功的人，他需要有个很高度的这种觉知。那这种觉知的能力实际上不可能有一种非常浮躁、痛苦、烦恼的心态来进行实现的。因此现在很多当前的一些成功人士，实际上在他们的事业的前线呢，有一个极其平静的心态和状态。
Calm mind or peace mind is also closely related to one's success. We all know those successful people need to do critical choices in their life, so a rational mind is very necessary. They cannot make a big decision with afflictive emotions or with sufferings, so that we can see how important a peace mind to your success.
因此有很多成功学，他们的学者们呢也认为，我们的实践当中的很多成功人士，在他们成功之前，或者说成功过程当中的话，就是对心态的 关注。也就是说，当我们出现一个不平静的、此起彼伏的这种心态呢，直接对你的事业有极大的危害和甚至损害。因此，现在我所看到的一些成功学当中呢，他们对心态的调整，也就是说参禅啊、闭目思维啊，以及呢就是关心自己的这种心态，澄清明净，这一点也极其关注。
It is that in the knowledge of success, when people during the process of access success, they pay close attention to his mind state. If one always experiences the ups and downs in his mind, then it will certainly impair his career. So I've read about such.Practice of meditation or examining your mind in the knowledge of success, because it's very important.
关于这一点，刚刚我们今天有全球很多的佛教徒进行考试，在考试的一个话题当中，他们今天很多人引用了吉天菩萨的一句话，就是说，知之宗尼库，不乱。信名成成名知道了吧，这是中宁库信名成啊，信成名啊，信成名。那么这句话就是我觉得不管是这个成功人士或者说是现在的世界的任何人士，其实很多人在生活当中遇到了许许多多的这种困难的时候呢，心不搅乱，心不烦乱，而且很坦然的去面对，这就是现在人特别需要的一种心态。
Today, many Buddhist practitioners have made their Dharma offering, and many people use the verses of Shantideva. It is that if a wise man wants to accept success, he needs to have a mind of serenity and calm. So I think no matter you want to be successful or you are in any position, you need to have an undisturbed mind, and you always need a mind of transparency and courage to face the difficulties.
这是我要讲的第二点，也就是说我们心绪情绪烦乱的这个过失知道之后呢，要对着情绪的重要性，或者说对着情绪的一些作用。
So that's the second point. We know the defect of the emotion. What's more important is we need to know theBenefit of work with your emotion.
那么下面第三点呢，我想跟大家分享一下。我们知道情绪烦乱的过失和情绪正好的功德以后，那么如何去这种心态就进行调整呢？也有一些按照佛教的思想跟自己的。这种生活当中的体验结合起来，给大家共同阐述。
What I want to share with you next is about how to work with the emotion, both in the Buddhist way and in from my own experience in their life.
首先，我们任何一个人的心态，特别痛苦啊。或者甚至生嗔恨心呐，就愤怒的心呐，在这个时候，很多这种心态是实际上是心胸很狭窄，而导致或者产生的。在这个时候，我们大乘佛教当中有一种叫做是慈悲观，而慈悲观是一种包容，就可以说是就放大自己的这种心态，只是这种一种信念。在这个时候呢，我们 个人就遇到的不管是大的痛苦还是小的痛苦，在这种心态面前呢，实际上它是非常渺小的。所以我认为我们的慈悲观实际上呢能解决许许多多世界上的情绪问题的最好的一个妙药。
So first, we'll talk about what causes our suffering. No matter the hatred or other afflictive emotions, actually it comes from our narrow mind. So in Mahayana teachings, we have the teachings of compassion. It's an approach to have an inclusive mind, to enlarge your mind. When we have such kind of compassion in our mind, then the suffering will be not a big deal. So I think for myself, compassion is the best medicine to solve all the emotional problems.
这样的佛教的慈悲观真的是它是非常伟大的一个思想。因为在这样的心态呢，实际上我们每一个人不一定能修得到的。首先你没有修这种慈悲观的时候，可能你身边发生的很多事情看不惯的，甚至觉得很讨厌。但是你一旦有了这种慈悲心的时候呢，你不但不讨厌它，而且呢有一种特别强烈的悲悯心想帮助它。
Compassion is a very great thought. With compassion in mind, I think it's not whatever each practitioner can access. Before you practice compassion, you may feel discomfortable for many things around you. But after you familiarize it in your mind, then you will cultivate such kind of warm-heartedness and willingness to help the people around you.
平常我们有一个小孩，他如果特别调皮的话，可能大家都很起厌烦心，但如果这个孩子一旦就是认为是我的孩子，把他当作自己的孩子，就这个时候，即使他有点调皮，但是呢，你会教他的，不会抛弃他，不会驱逐他的。
For example, if we see a naughty boy, we may feel impatient about him. But if you know this boy is your boy, then your mind will change. You will think you will not abandon it, and you will have the patience to teach him.
如果一个人的心里有这种慈悲的爱，这种慈悲的爱心，那么不管是他面前的发生的什么事，有人骂他，有人打他，有人恨他，实际上他都会可以理解他们，甚至呢也有会感谢他们。那这样的心态可能一般的人很难接受，但实际上我们的世界很需要这种思想。
With the compassion in your mind, what happened to you will be all acceptable, even if people may beat you or hate you. With this compassion in your mind, you will even cultivate a kind of understanding or gratitude to the people who hate you. For most of us may feel it's very hard to understand, but actually, this is what this world needs.
我们的上一个世纪呢，国家之间，部落与部落之间呢，就经常用一些战争来解决问题。而现在这个世界呢，虽然还没有到达这种境界，但是呢，都有一种对话，互相谦让，求同存异，来共同存活。我们很希望按照大乘佛教的这种理念，就将来整个全球的人们呢都互相一种爱和奉献来存活着，就如果度过的话， 那这是更美好的一个景象。
As we all know, in the last century, among countries or tribes, people all resort to wars to solve their problem. While today, such kind of phenomena seems to decline. We may have dialogue to seek living together and we may approach the living together through dialogue. While if we have the Mahayana teachings, we have the concept of Mahayana teachings. The world will be a better world because people will give each other love and dedication.
无论是家庭当中也好，还是人类在战争当中。都流下来的眼泪和血，都是我认为大多数是自私而来的，都是自私自利的心而出现的。
Actually, the tears or the blood we shed in the family or in the wars are due to our selfishness.
所以我们不管是个人或者是周围的群体。每一个人一样就是自己的爱心我们要学会就是原谅别人我们要学会忍让我们要学会包容这就是人类当前需要每个人需要关心的事也是整个全球的思想化全球的统一的思想来讲它就是最有价值的
Nurturing your compassion is very important, no matter to a personal level or to the community. Learn to forgive, learn to be tolerant. It's of the highest priority. It's the worldwide concern. I think that's what values most.
关于实现这样的这种大爱，要每个人充分利用自己的能力、才华、智慧，不仅仅是一个人自己的能力，还要我们发挥更多的作用。我特别喜欢前述前言观音菩萨，因为按照佛教的历史讲，前述前言观音菩萨，他想要关注世界上的许多苦难的众生。所以花一千个眼睛要帮助苦难的众生实际行动当中真的去亲手去做所以花一千个手所以我们每个人发这样的愿实际行动当中去做的话觉得这个世界呢应该是非常有乐趣的
In order to put this kind of compassion into practice,We need to fully make use of our talents and wisdom. It's not only important to a person or an individual, it's important to the whole world. I like the Avalokiteshvara. She has 1,000 eyes and 1,000 hands. According to the Buddhist history, the 1,000 eyes is used to know where the suffering happens, and the 1,000 hands.Used to helping those is needy. So I think everyone needs to make an aspiration. That is, we need to help others in their life and we need to put this kind of compassion into practice.
而我们为了培养这样的大爱实际上都要学会人与人之间的这种慈悲和关爱，更重要的，我们身边还有很多的动物，对他们的慈悲和慈爱也是不能放弃的。为了实现这样的目的呢，我们也经常保护动物、放生、 念观音心主等等。
In order to cultivate such kind of benevolent compassion, we need first nurture our compassion among the people around us. We need to show our affection to the people around us. But that is not enough. We also should not neglect the animals around us. We need to do more protection, such as life releasing and mantra chanting. To help them.
当一个人他出于一个非常广大的慈悲的心态当中的时候，其实他自身的痛苦和烦恼呢，全部就像雨水就融入大海一样，或者雪花融入大海一样，就全部跟大悲心就融为一体。这个时候不会有痛苦，是非常快乐的。
If one has a vast compassion, then it will be like a drop into an ocean. Compassion will dissolve all your suffering.
这是真正的幸福 ，happiness.
This is the ultimate happiness.
我们在座的大家应该出于一种这样关爱、大悲，也就是说。慈爱的心就便于所有的任何众生，在这种心态当中呢，我们前一段时间也要求每个人，如果自己有兴趣的话，念10000遍以上观音心主 Om Mani Padme Hum， 要不要我们一起念观世音菩萨的心主1-2分钟我们念一下，然后你们自己有兴趣的话呢，希望大家可以参与。
It's important for us to show our affection to all the sentient beings. So I've recently suggested that everyone need to recite the 10,000 Avalokiteshvara's mantra together to help the sentient beings. So let's just recite the Avalokiteshvara's mantra in the following minutes.
大家在念观音心主的时候呢，这样想，我就像是观世音菩萨一样的。所有的众生，我真正的爱所有的众生，心里面一边这样想，心一边呢，我们一起念。
When you chant, better have this kind of wish in your mind. You may imagine yourself, I am Avalokiteshvara, and I have this sincere love to all the sentient beings.
Om Mani Padme Hum, Om Mani Padme Hum, Om Mani Padme Hum.Om Mani Padme Hum, Om 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 Mani Padme Hum.Om Mani Padme Hum, Om 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 Mani Padme Hum.Om Mani Padme Hum, Om 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 Mani Padme Hum.这是一种我们的心可以处于爱的海洋当中，在这个时候呢所有的负面的情绪都了不可得。
Our mind can be emerged in the ocean of love, then at this moment all the negative emotions will disappear.
第二点 也就是说我们调整我们的情绪的方法当中呢还有一种智慧的方法来可以调整。
Actually, we can use the wise approach to wisdom approach to work with our emotional problem.
其实这个时候我们用自己的智慧去观察自己的心。当你观察自己的心的时候呢我们对外在的不管是嫉妒的贪婪嫉妒的嗔恨其实这都是不符合实际的一种心态。比如说我们看到一朵花就第一个念头就是觉得很好然后我再次的觉得很好很好在不断的产生这种贪念的时候呢我们的情绪带来一种夸张到一定的时候你产生欲望原来的美好的美丽的花朵你会自己归为己有或者说是会把它就是当作自己的在这个时候你跟原来对这个事物的正面的理解呢有一些反差所以这是我们因为智慧没有观察而导致的。
So when you examine your mind, you will find actually no matter extreme envy or extreme hatred is not the reality. For example, when you first see a very beautiful flower, then you will say, wow, it's too nice, it's too beautiful. You're probably always thinking of how beautiful it is. Then your attachment develop. That actually is kind of exaggeration. It's not a reality. After the attachment dominated your mind, then you find you want to possess it. So that's far away from the reality.
同样的，我们对产生嗔恨的对境。比如说原来这是一个敌人然后我觉得这是很坏很坏最后我原来就是对他刚开始产生的念头是一个重力的但最后对他的所有的功德全部会削弱最后呢把他看成就是非常坏的人最后我要想杀他想消灭他就这种念头是也是不符合实际的所以我们用智慧来观察贪观察嗔很多这个不合理的这些情绪全部断掉的话这是一种我们佛教当中有个叫做世俗地的智慧
Another example will be our hatred For example the object that you feel you project your hatred on it. Let's say an enemy, you may feel he's so bad. But actually, when you have that comment before you have that comment, you may think he's just a neutral person to you. But after you develop your hatred, then you will neglect all his merit. If you want to kill him, if your hatred developed, actually, this kind of thought is notReality is not the reality. So if we want to eliminate such kind of irrational emotion, we need wisdom to examine the reality of the thoughts. This is what called the wisdom of conventional truth.
如果佛教当中再进一步的再细化，这个时候有两种方法。第一种方法。刚才讲的中立的这种心态也进行观察未来过去现在我的这种嗔恨心和贪心或者说观察它的方位这个时候原来的这种心态呢好像在暂时的显现当中如梦如幻的存在但真正的它的实相呢了不可得就一点也是得不到的就这时候我们原来觉得是被一些痛苦啊烦恼啊而折磨啊这是非常可笑的事情 这是用深一地的第一种方法来，就是用观察的方法来去进行剖析的时候，最后找不到这种分别念。
There are two approach in the ultimate truth. First, we need to examine our neutral thought. We need to examine the thought, whether it is from past and whether it is exist in this moment and where it will be in the future. And we need to examine, is our thought exist in any place? Then we will come to the conclusion that all the phenomena is just dreamlike. If we further examine the real existence in itself, then we will find nothing can be found there. After these two steps, then you will find how ridiculous I was that I have such kind of thought, and I think it will exist.
这种观察方法不仅是佛教，现在的这个科学也是，比如说这个差别啊，它在现象上可以存在，但真正观察它的时候，最后它的连一个能量也事实到最后不存在。就这一点，我们现在的科学也是可以印证的。
Buddhist teaching has said it corresponds with scientific discoveries. Let's say the cup before the screen you saw. If we analyze its phenomena, then we analyze its appearance, then we'll find even the energy. We cannot even find the energy. Mm-hmm. This is what science will accept.
第二种观察方法，第二种观察方法呢，就是说我们的心态实际上自然放松。自然放松的时候呢，原来的各种频繁浮躁，特别痛苦的这种心态呢，就全部慢慢就是处于一种平静的状态当中。我今天在我的微博上发了一句话，不知道你们看过没有，也许大多数人没有看过。我是这么说的，我说当你的心无影力薄的时候呢，用心来内观自心，当下内观自己，在这个时候呢就你会发现，就是原来它是清空万里的。
The other approach is just to relax your mind, then you will find all your fickleness, all your unrestness, all your suffering is become kind of calm mind. So I've just posted a Weibo today, and it is that even if your mind is clouded by
Facebook.
Today I posted a Facebook. It is that even if your mind is clouded, then you examine it at this moment, then you will find all your negative emotions dissolved.
我们信呐，让它这样紧紧的时候，就像一杯水，或者是这个水浑浊的时候呢，永远的是现不出它的印象。当这个水慢慢就安住平静的时候，那水的本来的这种自性是澄清的，就不会有杂染的。所以我们的心其实当你真正安静下来的时候呢，所有的烦恼都会荡然无存的。
Let's say a cup of muddy water. It seems that muddy water is dirty. Actually, it's not the nature of the water. If you keep it still for a moment, then it will become cleaner. Actually, the clean water is the nature of it. Similarly, our mind, if you keep your mind in peace, then you will find the nature of your mind is never related to those afflictive emotions.
经常在想啊，心不能安住的人，不能认识自己心的这些人呢，表面上看呢是很正常的，但实际上呢，跟疯狂者没有很大差别。
At a glance, many people seem to be ordinary, but actually, if we do not really understand the nature of mind, you do not recognize the nature of your mind, then we are insane in some way.
是的，马上没有了。啊，好了，没有很多了。啊，我希望，我们每个人会有一些，情绪上的波动，也有各种在生活当中一些痛苦，但是这些都是实际上，就像天空的乌云一样，虽然它现象，但是在虚空当中它是不存在的。因此，希望当你不平衡的心态的时候呢，不要急着做一些不明智的事情，当你的心应该平静下来，好好的观察他的心，他的本体，在这个时候你会发现，原来你心里不开心的事情从来没有发生过。
I know each of us will experience the ups and downs in our mind, and also we go through the sufferings of life. Actually, it's just like the clouds in the sky. Although it appears, but it does not exist. So it is unwise for you to make a decision when you are suffering from the afflictive emotion. When we are in peace, we need to examine the nature of your mind. You will discover, actually, what happened in your mind do not really exist.
如果我们心很平静，心态很这种纯洁，这样的时候，每个人的家庭应该很幸福的。家庭的很多不幸福的不是因为物质和一些某种客观事物而发生的，大多数都是我们人的心，比较波动、比较烦躁而造成的。所以，人心清净者，家庭应该很快乐的。
We all need a peace and pure mind. As a person with a pure mind will have a happy family.All the unhappiness is not due to external means. It's actually the unrestfulness in our mind. So, if you have a pure mind, then you will have a happy life and a happy family.
如果家庭是很和睦的话呢，我们的家庭是实际上是社会的一个细胞。许多细胞就是非常的健康，那么整个社会的整体呢会和谐的，会快乐的。那么这样之后，整个世界上的所有的人类都会过着一个非常美满的生活。这样一来，我们的整个地球家园呢，就显得非常的阳光和灿烂。
It is very important to have a harmonious family, because family is the cell of society. If you have a healthy and happy family, then a happy and harmonious society will come up. All human being needs to lead a happy life. If you have such kind of harmony in your mind, then you will bring more brightness to this world, and all the global family will enjoy this brightness.
最后，今天是星期六，很多人放弃了自己的休息时间，有些人可能会打瞌睡，有些人可能比较辛苦。不管怎么样，我耽误了这么多的时间，但是我希望从中对你的内心带来幸福和快乐。谢谢大家。
I know today is Saturday and you got a lot to do. You take your time, maybe you just fall asleep and if you kind of tired, what I hope is you lead a happy life. That's all.
郭珍姐。
Thank you for
your
time.
郭珍姐，谢谢。还有个结语是吧？
Thank you for your time. I hope Rinpoche's thought-provoking talk may light up your life a little bit more. If you want to follow his journey of teaching, please check the new updates on his website, www.khenposodargye.org. Once again, today's teaching will be shared on the website. Please feel free to send us any of your comments. It's our great pleasure to hear from you. See you next time.
感谢您的聆听，希望仁波切具有启发性的教研能为您的人生增添喜悦。如果您想要了解更多的仁波切的信息，关注仁波切的开示，请官网查阅最新信息。本次开示也会共享在仁波切的官网上，如果您有任何建议，请给我们留言，我们将不胜感谢。谢谢大家。
Let's take all the merits withaccumulated today.
现在我们一起回向。
哦，孙南的耶丹加罗巴涅陀内尼巴赞那巴谢加，悉噶那揭瓦罗卓巴耶，卓贝卓列卓瓦卓瓦修。